Every night.
You're still doing it every night, aye?
Every fucking night for the last fucking however many days, 90 days or whatever it is. They can stand there as long as they fucking want, as some as a elected membership said. They can stand there as long as they want, they're not getting fucking anywhere. They're just not. They don't leave. They just aren't. They're just not gonna get anywhere. But that's our fault. You know what I mean?
How do
That's
you
our
mean?
problem.
No, well, that's.
It's not our problem. That's what I'm trying to say. It's not our fucking problem. Let them go home. The fucking parade's over. This year's over. Think about next year and you might get down. But, you know what I mean? They still want to go down fucking for last year and then next year and then the next year after that. They try to give them 10 out of 10 for trying, but they're just not going to get there. You know what I mean? They're just not. Don't be worried about it, young Thomas. They're just not going to get there.
No, I'm not worried about it. I just think they're the cesspit of
I know you're
humanity.
not. No, I'm not saying be worried about it, but just
No.
let them make fucking ball bags of themselves, you know what I mean?
They're the cesspit of humanity, and they judge. They are, but they judge, and they judge. The bit that I don't like is when they judge us as being the same as them, right? So when they say they hate us, all I've got. Right, for them, I try not to hate anybody because ultimately where that leads to is problems for the person who's holding the hate. So I try, and I've tried very hard not to have hate. As soon as somebody thing was in, to try and lose those bad feelings and then just think, well, I really should pity that person. So my mindset for these people is I've no get hatred in my heart for them. So they can throw their hate and say, oh, this cunt's this or that. And I just feel immense fucking pity for their worthless souls because I know their destiny. I know the way they're going to end up. It's no ending up in a good place for them. So I just fucking it's not that I worry for them, or I know that I worry for anybody connected or whatever. I pity their worthless souls, mate. Because really, unless they can get themselves a better education, like you said, I mean, unless they can educate themselves out it and just come to the conclusion, well, we're no better than anybody else. We have not got a self-entitlement to anything. To get anything in this world, you have to work at it. I mean, no, they're still holding back to 50, 60 years ago when everything was fucking given to them. But now,
Yes,
times have changed, and that's
and
the
I thought
point of the.
jobs were going to be handed down to them and fucking all that carry on.
Exactly.
They thought they were just going to come out of school and walk into a job, while our ones were away getting fucking taught
Degrees
and
in
fucking, they
education.
were away learning. They were, yes. And it's coming to fruition now and they don't know what to do with it.
And
Do you know what I mean?
of course, because the fact is, equal opportunities. If you go for a job now, I mean, if you went 50, 60 years ago and you were a Catholic and you had all the qualifications under the sun, then you could be denied a job when somebody for the Protestant school down the bottom of the street put in for the same job and they had one O level. You had fucking qualifications the length of your arm, and they turn up and they would get it. But those days are gone now, and that's the fact that
The
they can't
payment days
see.
aren't, no, I know what you're trying to say, but the payment days aren't gone now. You have to not let on who you are
Ah,
to
so
get certain
over there it's
jobs.
still the same, I bet you, aye, in certain places, aye.
And you have to be from a certain fucking area, and you have to be from fucking, do you know what I mean? You have to know the right fucking people. And if you don't, you know, the other ones know who you are, and then, you know what I mean? It's not going to look too good for you.
Because it's not
They're
that
gonna
big a
treat you like
city.
fucking shit.
It's not that big a city, Belfast, isn't it, no? I mean, when you
No,
consider it,
it's
it's
not
hard to
that.
fucking. I keep thinking back to my grandad, God rest him. He came from Ardoyne, and he actually worked in Harland and Wolff, and as he put it to me, I mean, it was
No,
because he never,
I
it's
never
because he's.
fucking made the fucking paint. Never made the paint with a lead paint.
Well, he had to go back instead of getting off the tram up at the Crumlin and walking into the Ardoyne and fucking giving his game away. And I mean, he had to go to his sister's who was married to a Protestant in a mixed area before he could go back home. That I mean, fucking. He had enough of it, as I say, 53, he came up.
That still happens nowadays.
Still happens now,
That
so
still
60
happens
odd
now.
years later, still the same.
But would you walk through a certain part of fucking Glasgow to get to your work? Would you even drive? Would you drive somebody through your fucking certain part of Glasgow? or would you drive around fucking certain part of Glasgow? You know what I mean?
I know.
It's just over here, you just need to be on your toes a wee bit more, sort of quicker and a lot of fucking, or a wee bit more alert and drum days, all the time, like, but I mean.
I know.
It's not going to change something. Do you know what I mean?
I know what you're saying.
But here, as your man said, or as your caller said earlier on, the cunts have died, and it's just us. It's up to us to buy, and their corpse has been sitting there for a fucking long time. We're doing nothing about it, and it's time to fucking buy them.
And what's the best way to bury them, in your opinion? How do we do that? How do we bury them?
That's a fucking big question, isn't it?
I mean, short for
so many ways you can't do it, and lose money, and you lose this, and you lose that, and you're not going to be able to fucking do this, and you're not going to be able to do that, fucking bollocks.
See, this is a short term and a short sighted way for Celtic fans and the Celtic board to think that we have to rely and need these people to survive, right? So now, I mean, they should have put it into implementation the first fucking year. They put down, we should have put in a word of notice and said, we are now going.
If you do this, this is the only way that we're going to accept these whenever you do this.
No, put in a word of resignation to Scottish football and apply to join the fucking Reimer Premier League or whatever it is in England to get into the bottom league, whatever division it is, and work through and do it that way and leave Scottish football. I mean, if they've got Swansea and Cardiff in the English Premier, then they could have Celtic and Celtic only. Because I think Celtic, if a Scottish football league is corrupt and fucked and there's no justice happening, then we shouldn't even be playing in this league, and we should be going to fucking England and saying, here we go, we'll work our way through your ranks, and that way, then we're no tied with these bastards. Then we've got lucrative games to play against Liverpool, Man United, and Arsenal, and we don't have to worry about fucking having them here to have a competitive league. I would rather Celtic play in the Premier League and be mid-table and have a competitive fucking league than having to turn up and watch every team every week playing with 10 men behind the ball and hitting on the break because they're too small a team to do anything. I'd rather Celtic be in a big league.
I'd rather Celtic playing fucking a championship or a League One or wherever the fuck I have.
Yeah.
I certainly would. Even if you fucking whatever happens, they can make a way up and struggle to do it. I don't give a fuck. I'd rather see it than fucking ever give them cons a hand. They're just more or less giving them a hand up.
See, but and see the way by actually saying, oh, you want them there or we need them, right? I mean, it's like saying, oh, you need a bullet in the fucking head. They cheated us. We're the main people who were cheated by them. So why would you ever want them to come back just because, oh, we get there's a big money spinner and there's a big league and we need a rival there? Well, then think of a bigger picture and think out the box and think differently. Things are there to change. The fact that they're no here, we should say, right, fuck it. Let's go into a different league and let's progress and move away from them and do something ourselves. We don't need to rely on them. Just because we had them for 124 years of our history doesn't need to mean to be they'll be there for another 124. Let's think of something different. Let's act on it and go and achieve a new, better future without them. I mean, it's something different, and we might have to take a few steps back. We might not be get European football. The crowds might dwindle even more, but it would be an adventure, and at least we wouldn't have to subject all us to what we've had to subject ourselves to as Celtic fans, because I mean, the previous boy on, I'm sick of it, you're sick of it. If anybody's got a different opinion, they're welcome to phone in at any time and change it.
But it's going to happen, man. Do you know that, don't you?
What's that?
I'm going to give him a hand up again, and you know it's going to fucking happen again, don't you?
I'm not going to accept it, mate. I might be written in the stars almost, but I refuse to accept it until those stars are shining in my face and I don't know, mate. I would love Celtic to do something. This is resolution. I'm going to be all at it, like a rash in a bad suit, mate. We should look to do something. Instead of worrying about them, we should look to get our own house in order and get a case against, put this out there in the board, get a resolution put out there or force it through that Celtic actually do something. I think this is the time that we've got to do. Forget putting blogs out there about Sevco, this and that. Let's fucking get our own house in order, get enough people together and say, right, we need to do something. Put the, like we're doing it now, I'm putting the case across it now, and that's what we should be looking to do. We don't need them here, we don't want them here, and we have to put a clearer message that we have to take a new stance as a club, and we need a new future away from them. Let's make it happen. Let's get fucking proper justice and make sure these cunts don't come back to do what they did before.
We're still not going to fucking raise the cunts beating us 5-1 on my 18th birthday. That's all I'm saying.
I know that, but fuck's sake. I know, I hear what you're saying. I know, I've got a plan.
It's not going to happen.
Listen.
Do you know what I mean?
You get yourself out of Glasgow the next time. I'll get the 18th decorations. Go and find the clothes that you were wearing. How many years ago is that now? 10, 12 years ago? Get the clobber you were wearing. Remember what you did that night.
Place.
Invite everybody fucking over. And this is going to be an 18th birthday. Get it over and get over. We will have an 18th birthday for all your internet band pop mates, right? We are your real mates. So why don't you head back in at 18? Do you still know them?
Well, yeah.
Do you still know those mates back at 18? Right, we'll get them over here and have an internet Bamport reunion with all your old mates and your new mates. And then we'll have an 18th birthday party to celebrate. Even better, get them over here and we'll have an 18th party, right?
And his body flowers are going to say sorry.
I'll get that cunt's phone number and I'll fucking make him say sorry, right? I'll get his fucking number, right, and we'll get him on.
If you get dad, I'll come over.
Right, I'll get his number and I'll get an apology. You better go over here for your 18th and we'll wipe that bad memory out. That's the only way. Fucking wipe it out. Fucking, we'll rub it out, mate. We'll get that fucking rubbed out. We'll sponge it from history. If these cunts have got selective amnesia, that's what we'll develop in you. We'll sit you down and we'll pour you full of every kind of intoxicant until that memory is gone. And then we'll wake you up and we'll say, right, that's you fucking cured. There you go. I'll cure you, mate. I'll cure you that 18th bad trip. Don't worry. Fucking bastards, mate. Fucking bastards, mate. They're fucking cheating cunts.
Thomas, God bless you.
God bless me. Right, I'm gonna get a PLC defender on in a minute. I'm going to get a Bulgian who likes to defend the PLC. So I want a square go with this guy. He's a defender of the PLC. My dander's up. I'm wanting to fucking
just,
take him.
Just try not to curse at him. Not for about 5 minutes in. Get your point across and then curse at him.
He's a good guy. He knows I love him anyway. He knows I love him. I just like his viewpoint at times when it comes to defending the board. But I don't think he's for real. I think he's just saying it to wind me up, to get my dander up. So we'll see what he's saying, right? Right, mate. God bless you. Phone in any time, Michael. You're more than welcome to come on.
God bless, mate.
Right, speak to you soon.
No bar. See you later.
Cheerio. Cheerio, mate. Old Michael for Belfast, Westfast. You got to love technology. Look at that. For Belfast to the north of Glasgow. And this tune is about the south of Glasgow. Laughter.